Hello to all of our fellow and future hobbyists out there. My name is Matthew, and I'm your BRS beginner guru. All we're going to do right here, right now, is answer your top five questions about the Hanna Alkalinity Checker. Question number one, how do you use the Hanna Alkalinity Checker? Use a Phillips head screwdriver to remove the battery cover and install the included battery. Replace the cover and tighten the screw. Press the on-off button to power the checker on. Fill a cuvette with 10 milliliters of sample water and screw the top back on. Hold the cuvette by the top and bottom and wipe any blemishes or liquid off the sides of the cuvette with a soft cloth. Place the cuvette into the checker and firmly close the lid. Press the on-off button and wait until C2 is displayed. Remove the cuvette from the checker and screw the cap off. Place the plastic tip onto the 1 millimeter syringe and draw up 1 milliliter of reagent into the syringe. Just a quick note here that the liquid itself will not go into the syringe, but just the plastic tip. So you're gonna draw up the liquid until the black plunger reads zero. Add the 1 milliliter of reagent to the cuvette, replace the cap, and gently invert 5 times. Don't shake. Your goal here is to gently mix the test water and the reagent without causing bubbles, which can skew the results. Again, hold the cuvette by the top and bottom and wipe down the glass with a soft cloth, being sure to remove any smudges or liquid. Place the cuvette back into the checker, close the lid tightly, and press the on-off button again. In a few seconds, the result will be displayed as degrees of carbonate hardness or DKH. Be sure to rinse the vial and the tools after every use with either distilled water or RODI water and allow them all to dry completely. Question number two, what should alkalinity be in a reef tank? Somewhere between 7 and 12 DKH. I personally shoot for a range of between 8 and 9 DKH. Maintaining alkalinity in a tank is really important because it also helps maintain the pH of your tank. And if you're looking for an in-depth 22-minute video all about alkalinity, Ryan made an absolute beast of a video and we'll put the link down below. Question number three, how do you calibrate the Hanna Alkalinity Checker? Well, that part's really easy because we actually walked you through the calibration during our answer to question one. Since the Hanna Checker needs to be calibrated before each use, it's just automatically built into the instructions. So when you put 10 milliliters of tank water into the cuvette, when the Hanna Checker read C1, you were actually calibrating it. Question number four, how accurate are Hanna checkers? Well, if you follow the instructions to a T and your tank water is around 77 to 78 degrees, then the results are accurate to plus or minus 0.3 DKH. And question number five, how high does the Hanna Alkalinity Checker measure alkalinity? Well, the Hanna Alkalinity Checker has a range of 0 to 20 DKH. Hanna makes good products. Now, while Hanna checkers aren't my favorite test kit for every single thing out there, when it comes to testing alkalinity, the Hanna Alkalinity Checker is by far and away my favorite. It's affordable, super easy, and highly accurate. It's just a great product all around. And let me just tell you guys, now's probably a really good time to pick this up. So check out the link below if you're ready to buy the Hanna Alkalinity Checker. And as always, thank you for watching. Happy reefing, be well. We'll see you next time.